Hey everyone, in this video we'll be going over how incredibly useful ChatGPT can be when properly integrated with data, or even more so, when integrated into a bulk message sequencing automation. You probably all know how you can ask ChatGPT a question or give it a prompt, and ChatGPT will intelligently answer you. But when you combine this with a source of data, and you can quote that data to automatically pass it over to ChatGPT, you can have ChatGPT process that information for you, and output new information that you didn't have. And let's take this LinkedIn profile as example. I told Jobin to in bulk extract a few profiles, and let's say that these are all potential clients for me, and I want to offer them my services, say as a recruiter, or I just want to sell them something. I can tell ChatGPT to read all these inputs that I've automatically extracted from their LinkedIn profiles, and ChatGPT can use this information to target the potential pain points of my clients, or the potential mission, or basically the goal that they're trying to achieve. And I can then use that pain point or that mission as my leverage for convincing them why they need my service or why they need that certain thing that I'm offering. And let's say I want to message Sandra. I can generate ChatGPT prompts directly from here, and I already have a couple templates at my disposal. Say I want to leverage on three specific role challenges that Sandra is facing. So I'm telling ChatGPT to identify the challenges that Sandra has by giving it as input the current role they're working as, which is Director at Strategic Partnerships, and then to also use the summary and job descriptions to get more context and create a more relevant response. I'm then telling it to output everything in a simple list of three tasks in a comma-separated sentence so that I can easily manage it once it gets added into my main text. And to view how it auto-compiles, let's view the preview. And the main three tasks that Sandra is interested in is, well, developing revenue, penetrating new markets, and maintaining relationships. Let's now give it a more practical example. Here I've combined a message with both independent smart fields, quoting the first name, the role, and the company of Sandra, and then also the ChatGPT prompts that we've created earlier. In this case, the three role challenges that Sandra would face. And I've also added another prompt for three potential competitor companies. So now, as you can see, it's saying, "Hi, Sandra, as Director of Strategic Partnerships at Expedia Group, I'd imagine you focus on building partnerships, identifying opportunities, and increasing revenue." The prompt here changes, but it is still coherent with the tasks and goals that Sandra is interested in. You can also find the three competitors of the Expedia Group company listed here as well. As you can see, thanks to the combination of all these smart fields and ChatGPT prompts, the entire message that we're sending is a lot more compelling. It no longer becomes just a "hello, let's have a call" message, where you kind of push your luck in the hopes that they somewhat blindly schedule that call, and then only from that point onwards can they properly understand what you're offering. But whereas with ChatGPT, you can actually manage to give them that convincing sales pitch relevant to exactly what they do, so you can actually grab their attention straight away on the very first step. This immensely increases the odds of them saying, "Oh wow, I do need help with that, let me have a call with them." And with Jobin.cloud, you can automate all that at scale. So I can actually select a large group of, say, multiple sales directors, if sales directors are my clients, and have ChatGPT create a compelling argument as to why my services are something that they want. And of course, keep in mind that you can create your very own prompts, so you can have ChatGPT help you out with exactly what you're interested in. Furthermore, there's even a ChatGPT rewriting function. As you may have noticed, this text isn't actually perfect. The role that Sandra has is Director, Strategic Partnerships, not something that you would actually write in a sentence. Also, the ChatGPT prompts start with a uppercase letter, which might be off-putting. In this case, these are just small and minor errors, but in some cases, if you're not too experienced with prompts, you might end up receiving an actual prompt output that doesn't fit with your main text as well as you would have hoped for. That's why you can use that rewriting function to automatically tell ChatGPT to clean up and rewrite your entire message, making sure that everything is perfectly coherent. In fact, let's actually see how this alters our final message. As you can see, the sentence has been corrected, whereas the role is now Director of Strategic Partnerships. The casing on the list has also been changed. And of course, prompts regenerate each time, so they aren't necessarily always the same values. But just like that, we can safely make sure that your message regardless of how many prompts or smart fields you've used, will always make sense and be perfectly coherent. So even if you're not experienced with using ChatGPT prompts, to make the prompts properly fit with the other text that you're writing in your message, this will tell ChatGPT to clean up and rewrite the entire message so you can say goodbye to any typos or incoherent sentences. And with Jobin Cloud, you can do all this at scale with a fully automated sequence. There's both a free trial and a free forever plan, so why not give it a try?